a new researcher in any field is inquisitive for knowing what are the fundamentals of research. What is the meaning of research, its kinds, its nature, and scope? What are the scientific and normative research? What are the objectives, characteristics of research? And obviously, social science research involves ethics. Ethics in social sciences research. These are the queries of a new researcher in social sciences. Of course, these are conventional queries, but these conventional queries of research methodology in social sciences are today challenged. Threatened. And warned social scientists that the time is changed. The time may have come to working on multiple hypotheses, utilizing new AI and machine learning tools, strategies in collection of data, and their analysis. I will elaborate these new developments in this presentation, simultaneously discussing what is research. What is research, its scope, nature? These are, as I said, the consistent issues. But we are discussing them in 2020, when our planet is fighting against COVID-19 pandemic for survival of humanity. We are talking these issues when social media networks have become an integral part of our life. And they are affecting the functioning of economic, political, and social institutions. At present, technology like AI has uncontrolled power of influencing everything at its wish. Therefore, when we are going for research and making a career in academic research, we should be aware of these developments. Only then we can define what is research and its other characteristics. The studies of social sciences will fail if they are not able to predict or they are not able to analyze almost every dimension which affects the functioning areas related to social sciences. Otherwise, our studies will become irrelevant or illegitimate. Well, as we accept that the social sciences deal with society and society is formed by people, and therefore social sciences study people and people are related to that. We moved further and started studying human psychology. We further moved and started encouraging interdisciplinary research. And we should also keep in mind that these research are done in a structured system in the university. First, you have to study research methodology for a few months. Then a professor is nominated as a research supervisor. Then you have to present research design. And you have to complete, obviously, your study within a specified duration. Thus, there is a structure. Then you choose a topic, area, and a problem with single hypothesis and prove or disprove that hypothesis. Hypothesis is a statement about a preconceived idea that leads your research. The most of researches of social sciences in India are case studies. So conventionally, we assume that research is a study which should be valid, reliable, trustworthy, and systematic. But it is still volatile. Why? First, the companies are focused on solving problems. But social sciences researches do not solve the problems. Our task is not solving the problems. That is the task of companies. Our task is to advance, present a status of information. These researches moves us ahead towards future from present status of knowledge or information, whatever you say. We use these terms very casually, no problem. So we advance present status of information and move towards the future. Thus, social science researches present truth, grassroots realities, like investigative journalism. But truth, again a rope term. Therefore, social science researches should be humble with open mind, because findings of every research bring opposite findings, and we will move to further studies. Because the researches involve capabilities of a researcher or his or bias probability. These are the variables involved in researches. So there is no place of arrogance in research. But research should be rigorous. Only then it will be rational and systematic. And in 2020, when we are talking these issues, rigorousness is too required. As you know, that the dynamism is a reality, nothing is static. It decides the nature and scope of research. Your effort will make your study more efficient and accurate. Why I emphasize it? I give you a few examples. During coronavirus pandemic, a tweet is posted claiming that Johns Hopkins University report anticipated 40 crore virus patients in India. It was very quickly verified by Times of India as fake news. Another example, more interesting. In April 13, in 2013, a tweet is posted, quoting Associated Press source, informing that two explosions took place in which Mr. Barack Obama is injured. This tweet was returned 4,000 times within 5 minutes. The stock market crashed, huge money was washed away. Very soon it is verified fake. Similarly, mob killings in India, mass genocide of Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar were fake and spread with manipulation of technology. As you see, the hate and crime are sold online through the world. We see it in France, Brazil, Myanmar, New Zealand, India, everywhere. Second very important example, particularly for the research students of political science, public policy, governance, election studies, is the Brexit referendum in England. The people of United Kingdom decided to leave European Union, as you all know. Later, the British officials released documents and emails allegedly claiming that the Cambridge Analytica did work for Leave EU campaign and used Facebook data and its advertisement targeting tools. The British Parliament summoned Mr. Mark Zuckerberg to testify. That was refused by him. This episode exposed technological giants' capability to influence public opinion throughout the world. Similarly, in 2016 US president election, when Mr. Trump was elected, the US intelligence agencies highlighted Russian election meddling. However, Mr. Putin denied Russian role. But during investigation, it came out that wave of false informations were flown down during election process by Macedonian hackers. The studies have been conducted how lies is spread and false news are more followed. New informations are regularly gathering without knowing the source. The world governments have no control over technological giants. The political establishments, they also hire them. It has become a necessity. The point is, what are the questions today which social sciences have to answer? These issues are raised in a context, of course. That's why what is research in a context or in general? The question is, for example, a political science, that how we can save our democracy from AI manipulations. Who are synthetic generators of informations? How we can reach of truth in the age of misinformations? It seems that we have reached at a point where end of reality is a reality. Obviously, that is credibly dangerous, very dangerous. As far as India is concerned, and not India, it is everywhere. I went in Crimea, Poland, Malaysia, even Istanbul. Istanbul has a mixed place of European and Asian culture. Everywhere I found youngsters crazy to go Western countries, to adopt new cultures, earn more money. Everywhere the capitalism, market capitalism, whatever you say, capitalism and market economy in developing countries encourage people to think big and pursue dreams. But it requires education, training, and entrepreneurship. The demographic dividend of India is such that youth comes easy. 65% of our population is under 35. The challenge is to groom them into leadership. Today, socio-economic environment in developing countries, including India, only money is preferred. It has transformed the nature of Indian family. The market economy has made individuals and products artificial. I would say nobody speaks truth, nobody wants to listen truth. The market economy is creating illusions. People are happy in living in illusive world. People should remain stupid. Only then they can be manipulated. A common argument, of course, privately given by industrialists and, sorry to say, politicians. But we also accept that politics has autonomy and has its own rules and languages. Anyway, the point is, here, that live today, forget tomorrow, and micro family ideals gave us more worries and feeling of insecurity. Hobbes' state of nature seems prevailing underneath. Our identities and values are challenged. The rampant poverty, financial commitments, old age worries, inflation, corruption, sky high real estate prices, black money, increasing gap between poor and rich. Money has made mass population confused and defensive. And COVID-19 attack also exposed and dinged it. We deal education system. In market economy, youth, we found that youth is not keen to knowledge or education. They are behind shortcut money gains. During elections, we see people are cashing their votes with money, or they know that they are only touched during elections, and after elections, they will not have any control over politics, over politicians. The spirit of entrepreneurship, knowledge, or education is absent. People are keen to follow rule on paper. The credibility, humanity, truthfulness, and patriotism are losing their utility. The market economy is not successful to build a talent pipeline as it is required. The social insight and cultural considerations, if you do study, will expose it. So in such a scenario, researchers in social sciences must understand these challenges and redefine, reset definition of research, its nature, and obviously its scope. The society, people are not only scope. The area of research is beyond it, mingling with invisible factors who are affecting human life and their interactions. The laws are disrupted by technology. The technology has crime scenes with evidence, but we are helpless. The 100 years of old democracies are threatened, as we see in England. As iron sharpens iron, the use of AI and machine learning tools and strategy in social sciences researches are need of the day. It is very interesting. AI people also use many hypotheses at a time and collect data related to all through algorithm. See the trends and predict future very accurately. Are we ready to adopt this? Thank you.